One of the unique things about this style is that the applications behind the movements have been preserved. This very first movement, opening here, this is very similar to, you've heard of the Chinese martial art, Xing Yi. They have a similar movement like that. So it really has kept a lot of the principle for the Chinese aspects. So if he comes in with a punch, I'm using this hand to parry and attacking the neck. So it's a very simple application. So by the time he finishes the attack, he got hit. It's not like I'm going over here and then attacking him with a secondary strike, which then he has a chance to attack me. So you always have to be, it can be like a tennis match, where you do something, and then I do something, and then he does something, and we're taking turns passing the ball back and forth. You always have to be in the tempo that's slightly ahead of his tempo. So by the time he finishes his one technique, he got hit. So this is more realistic martial arts tempo. So he gets hit the moment that he tries to hit you. So this is what's happening in the upstairs. In the downstairs with the feet, is you're using your foot to land here. You're also trapping the foot, so you're also displacing his foundation. So there's a lot of this leg trapping that you see happening within this style. If you are, we'll do it from this side. So if I decide to do the inside, it's the same principle. So whether I defend to his outside, or whether I take it on the inside, it's the same principle. You don't see a lot of this in Kojo Ryu. A lot of these hard bone blocks. It's probably about 90% open hands. So most of the strikes are fingertips, or using the thumb knuckle in this fashion. So you have to really develop that. That's basically used in the kata when I do this movement. Kick, stepping here. I could be using the fingertips. Primary target is the throat. Of course, it could be the eyes, or anyone along the pressure points on the neck. But also using this thumb, first knuckle of the thumb, straight into the throat.